question for you. Have you ever had an issue that you really kind of wanted to keep under the surface? You really didn't want anybody to know about, or at least not to point out? I think about our text this week in Luke chapter 6, where Jesus is at a synagogue on the Sabbath, and there's a man there with a withered hand. I can't help but think that that man, for whatever time period that hand was withered or deformed, that he didn't want that to be pointed out, that it was something that he didn't want to interrupt his connection with others. Maybe it'd be more appropriate if I just said, what issue would you like to remain hidden out of the public eye? It's wild to me that on that particular Sabbath day, Jesus asked this man to stand up and stretch out his hand, this withered hand. When he first stood to his feet, I wonder if he was holding it behind him or just to his side, not wanting it to be the issue. For whatever reason, Jesus was asking him to stand. Or maybe he was anticipating Jesus to heal his hand. For whatever reason he was there on that day, I bet in that moment, standing up and stretching out his issue had to be hard. Jesus, I believe, zeroes in on our issues. I think he knows whatever it is that we want to keep hidden. Maybe it's a moral issue. Maybe it's a thing in our past where we've screwed up badly and we're just afraid it's going to come back and haunt us in this moment. That someone's going to discover and think less of us. That because of whatever our issue is, our struggle, our defect, we won't be accepted. I know that on that day, the end result for that man was certainly the acceptance of God and the love of God, and that his issue did something that one of my mentors used to say, that our problems only make us candidates for a miracle. On that particular day, his issue, his problem, his deformity made him a candidate for a miracle. What if we looked at our issues that way? What if we began to see the things that we struggle with not as something that should pull us away from God, but actually pull us toward God, make us ready to receive something from Him? Maybe a healing. Maybe something's broken and it's mended. Maybe it's a relationship that is our issue and it's restored. Or maybe just the cloud of shame that used to just hover on us is suddenly lifted because we stretch out and give our issue to Jesus. Today, I don't know what your issue is, but I bet you got one. And I wonder if today you would have the courage with me in this moment to just say, here it is, Jesus. This is my issue. My broken marriage, my addictive behavior, the shame of my past, my fear of rejection, an illness, some kind of emotional or psychological trauma or defect. This is it. And let Jesus touch you. I think that's what confession is. I think whenever we confess, we are agreeing with God about our current condition. But we're also asking God not to let that current issue hold us back from going forward with Him. Oh, Lord Jesus, I just pray that today, Lord, we would have the courage to recognize I got issues. But Lord, I don't want to hold them back. I want to reach forward and give them to you. And so, Lord Jesus, be with us today. Help us to be people courageous enough to trust you with whatever our issue is. In Jesus' name, amen. I look forward to seeing you with or without issues here soon. God bless you. Have a great day.